In this video, we will see about access specifier in Java. Access specifier is also known as a modifier in Java. So basically, there are four types of access specifier present in Java. First is public access specifier, second is private access specifier, third is default access specifier, and fourth one is protected access specifier. So firstly, we will see about the public access specifier. So see here, this is our Java project. Inside this Java project, so this is one Java project. Okay, inside this Java project we have a two package. This is your package 1 and this is your package 2. So package 1 consisting of two classes. This is class 1 and this is second class. Okay, and inside a package 2 again two classes are there. This is one class and this is another class. So suppose I am using the method name, or before method name I am using the specifier as a public. That means what? I can use that method inside anywhere in the same project. That means what? I can use that method inside a class 1 also, inside a class 2 also, inside a class 3 also, as well as inside a class 4 also. That means what? I can use anywhere inside a same project. So this is nothing but the public access specifier. Second is what? Private access specifier. Suppose I am using method name before method name as a private. In that case, there is a limitation before using that method. Suppose I used, or suppose I declare method inside a class 1. So suppose my method name is what? Private. My method name is suppose AK is my method name. So my method name is what? Private. That means what? I cannot use this method outside the same class. So there is a limitation while using this method. So scope of a private access specifier is what? It is limited to that class only. So this is nothing but the private access specifier. I cannot use this method outside the class 1. So this is a private access specifier. Third is what? Protected access specifier. Suppose I am using method name as a public, as a protected. So my method name is what? Protected AK1. So this is my method name. So I am using the specifier as a what? Protected. So I can use this method outside the class but within the same package. So see here, in package 1 two classes are there. Here is class 1 and here is class 2. So what is protected access specifier says? It says that you can use the method outside the class but inside a same package only. So what is the outside class of class 1? So see, outside a class 1, class 2 is there. And is it in the same package? Yes. Class 2 is present in package 1 only, and class 1 is also present in package 1 only. So see here, I can use this protected method. That is, I can call the AK1 method in a class 2. So see here, whether I can see I can call the AK1 is in class 3? No, because class 3 is present in a different package. So I cannot use the AK1 package outside the package 1. Okay, so this is a protected access specifier. Next is what? Default access specifier. So see, suppose I am using here default keyword before a method name, and suppose my method name is what? Method. So see here, what is the scope for this default method? I can use this method outside the class but inside a same package only. That means what? I can call this method in class 4 also, because we can call the default method outside the class but within the same package only. So question arises that then in both cases, that means in private protected as well as in default, We can call the method outside the class, but within the same package only. This is the scope of protected as well as default access specifier. Then what is the difference between these two access specifier? So see, if I want to use this protected method outside the package only, outside package also, in that case I can use this AK1 method here, but by using a inheritance concept. So I can use this AK1 method in class 3 also by using a concept of inheritance only, but I cannot use this method outside the package. So I cannot use this method in class 2 or in class 1, but I can use this AK1 in a class 3 as well as in class 4 also by using a concept of inheritance. So this AK1 we can call in class 3 as well as in class 4 only by using a concept of inheritance. But if we cannot use this method in class 1 as well as or in class 2, because the scope of default access specifier is within the same package only. So this is a difference between protected and default access specifier. So I will write here types of access specifier and scope of access specifier. Types is what? First is public. Scope of public access specifier is throughout a project. Scope of private access specifier is what? Within a class. Third, default. Scope within package. And fourth is what? Protected. Scope is what? Throughout the project. By using inheritance.